On July 13, 2021, the FDA issued a warning with a possible association between Johnson & Johnson vaccine and Guillain-Barre syndrome, a rare neurological condition. So what is Guillain-Barre syndrome and what are the recommendations now regarding taking the vaccine if you had Guillain-Barre syndrome before? Let's take it from the neurologist. So Guillain-Barre syndrome, or GBS, is a rare neurological condition when the immune system attacks its own nerves and will usually affect the covering of the nerves called myelin, and those nerve covering will cause damage to the nerves. Symptoms can be weakness and numbness, and sometimes it can even reach to the breathing muscles and cause need for mechanical ventilation and hospitalization. This condition is considered a rare condition, and usually the occurrence of this condition in the United States is estimated to be between 3,000 and 6,000 cases in a year. This is also treatable with medication that we can give during the hospital stay. So in the release, the FDA said there is observed increased risk of GBS after COVID vaccine. A few months ago, I did a video about the association between COVID-19 itself and Guillain-Barre syndrome and if the COVID vaccine was safe. And at that time, the information that was available showed that there is no association or any risk with GBS in COVID vaccines. And now, after the FDA release, people started seeing this video and blasted the comment section with saying that this is wrong information. Well, yeah, I agree. It is an evolving field and we learn as we go. And today's video, I'm updating you for the recent and most updated information. So out of 12.5 million doses of Johnson & Johnson vaccine given in the United States, there were 100 cases of preliminary reports of GBS after this vaccine. And this is dependent on the vaccine adverse event reporting system, VAERS. And this is a powerful tool to monitor the safety of the vaccines. And oh boy, after this FDA release, all the news outlets started reporting this and saying that Johnson & Johnson vaccine will cause paralysis or this GBS condition. And we should know that this was not reported in other mRNA vaccines like Moderna and Pfizer. So as a neurologist, I should tell you that GBS is a condition that has lots of mimickers, means like condition looks like it, but they are not GBS. And the diagnosis often is confusing and might not be clear, especially at the beginning of the condition. So we should be very clear if this is the final diagnosis in those cases, but I will consider that all of them had GBS. So what is the real incidence of GBS and how likely it will happen after COVID vaccine? So if we do the math, there were 100 cases in 12.5 million doses. So the estimation is about between 5 to 10 cases per million. And this is a very, 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 very low chances. So the percentage is 0.0008%. And this is an extremely rare situation. And we should know that the chances of death from COVID-19 is about 1 to 3%. So if we worry that 8 out of the million will get GBS and not get vaccinated, out of this million people, there will be 25,000 deaths in those 1 million people if they don't get vaccinated. So we should be very aware of the real numbers and not outblow this like 8 to 25,000 deaths. So we should always be putting things into consideration and into the real sizes. And I totally understand if it is you, then this is you. This is like 100% for you. But you know, on the general population, this incidence is very, very rare. And please let me know down in the comments if you had any adverse reactions to the vaccine and if you did report this reaction to the vaccine adverse event reporting system. So finally, let's talk about the recommendations. So if you do not have any history of GBS before, those complications are very, very rare and you should not be worrying about them. And you should get vaccinated because the potential risk of those complications is extremely rare, and the potential complications or even death from COVID-19 itself is very high, so you should get vaccinated. And if you did have history of GBS before, it is advised to maybe get a Pfizer or Moderna vaccine if they are available to you. However, if the only vaccine that is available to you is Johnson & Johnson vaccine, I would highly recommend that you go and take this vaccine, because the risk of complications from COVID-19 are much, much higher than this very small risk of GBS worsening or even happening to you. And to learn more about COVID-19 vaccines, please watch those videos, and see you in the next one.